So if you want beautiful, full, plump lips, your first step should be exfoliating. You should always exfoliate your lips no matter what, even if you're not really going for a super plump look, because this will make your lipstick go on super smooth and your lips will look their best. So I have some lip exfoliators that I'm actually really addicted to, and my favorites are by Lush. This one is in chocolate. This one's so good, it's really hard to actually not want to eat it. And this one's also the same way. And I have Sugar Plum Fairy, and I absolutely love these. A more affordable lip scrub is by e.l.f., and I actually really love those because they come in a lipstick tube, so they're really easy to keep in your purse when you're on the go or traveling. So I'm gonna use my fave Sugar Plum Fairy, and you could add a little bit of water to your lips or to the scrub in your fingertips and apply it to your lips. So now that we've exfoliated our lips are smooth, they're ready to be plumped naturally. I'm gonna show you guys a couple tricks you could do to plump your lips. Now, some of these are not gonna be for everyone. Some of them I recommend more than others, and I'll touch on that as we keep going. You guys may have seen these little plumping devices around, and they work. They really do. But the thing is, these can bruise your lips if you're not careful. So I would recommend really not overusing these. If you're going to use them for maybe taking a photo or something quick, because these aren't gonna last all day long. Your lips will eventually go back to their normal state. This is a lip plumping device by the brand Full Lips. And basically what you do is you apply it to your lips, and there's kind of like a suction factor to it that when you suck in like this, your lips get sucked up into the device and blood rushes into your lips, making them look fuller, but this does not last. This will probably last about maybe 30 minutes or less. Kind of leave your lips in here for probably like 20 seconds. I wouldn't do anything longer than that. This will help you also create a guide for when you overline your lips. So this is a before of my lips, and now I'm gonna go ahead and apply the device. My lips did just get a little fuller. So now I'm gonna go in with the oval device. And as you can see, my lips are huge. They're like massive. I'm first gonna line my lips with Nude by Milani. And what you wanna do when overlining your lips is you wanna make sure that you're not overlining on the sides of your lips, or else it will look really, really odd. You wanna overline your Cupid's bow and also the bottom area of your lip while following your natural lip line. So now we're going to contour our lips using Spice by Milani. This is a really great lip pencil for contouring. And what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna create a line in the center of my lips. Now, if you guys have seen pictures of celebrities like Angelina Jolie, a lot of these celebrities have natural lip lines that make their lips look fuller because they naturally have full lips. So to get that look, you're just gonna draw a little line right in the center. The benefits of wearing a liquid lipstick over overlined lips is that this will increase the longevity of the lip line. So for instance, if you coat this over the lip liner, it will last just as long as your liquid lipstick will. I love the Ofra liquid lipsticks because they don't make your lips feel dry. They're just the best and they last so long. So I'm first gonna go in with Bel Air. And now I'm gonna take Pasadena and I'm gonna ombre my lips. By ombreing your lips, it makes your lips look like they have a lot of depth and a lot of curvature to them, so they'll look fuller. And you basically wanna leave the center of your lips completely blank with that first lipstick you applied. Just use the darker one to just darken it up. Something you can do that will really prolong everything is put a lip plumper over the top. Now, I have some favorite lip plumpers that I really, really love, and they're all by Too Faced, but any of these will work just fine. You can actually do this whole thing without using the device if you use the plumper, but if you want it to last even longer, then put a gloss that is plumping on top of everything. I've always felt that glosses make your lips look the fullest, even more full than anything else, even overlining. It's kind of hard to ignore because the light kind of hits the lips and it really highlights everything. So we're gonna go over the lips with the plumping gloss. I'm gonna go over the top of my lips with the Too Faced Lip Injection Glossy in Spice Girl. The last and final step is to pick up a bronzer that's a little bit more cool tone, so something you'd contour with. I'm gonna pick up this bronzer in my Makeup Revolution palette, and I'm gonna use this to apply to the bottom of my lip. Now, what you wanna do is you wanna create a shadow that looks like your lip is literally hanging over. So we'll just go right underneath and use a damp sponge to really blend everything. And it's as simple as that. My lips are plump, they're gonna last all day, and they look really, really full, almost like I have lip injections, which is crazy. This effect will last for a little bit because we layered so many different products over each other. They're gonna look full for a longer period of time. That's it, guys. I hope you enjoyed the tip, and if you did, please let me know down below. I'm gonna be reading the comments and replying, and I would love to know what you thought of this Tip Tuesday. Remember to subscribe if you haven't, hit the bell button so you don't miss any more videos from me. Share this video with friends who wanna plump their lips naturally. And thank you guys so much for watching today. Have an amazing Tuesday, and I will see you all in my next video. Thank you.